Hey there, friends. Thanks for checking in. What is happening right now in Virginia is fascinating. The way the Democratic-controlled Congress is implementing this gun control, you have a Senate, a Congress, and a governor's seat all held by Democrats, and they are implementing gun control legislation as they said they would. When they gained the power, they said their number one priority was to implement gun control. They do it because they say that we need a safer society and that it is common sense and it's gun safety and nobody should be against this. Many times they say even the gun owners want stricter gun control. We want universal background checks. We want assault rifle a confiscation, and we want red flag laws. A bunch of other stuff were piled on, like magazine restrictions and a couple other things. This is happening at mock speed, and it's kind of hard to keep up with everything, but this is where we are standing right now, where these people are telling us, or telling the people of Virginia, how they need to live their lives. Now, I believe that this is overall how the Democrats want this whole gun control thing to go down. They want to tell us how we are supposed to live. This reflects not just Virginia, but the rest of the country. If there was one thing I agreed with Obama on in his 8 years in office, just one thing that I agree with him on is that elections have consequences, and we are seeing that right now in Virginia. And the main thing that really got this thing going was confiscation. They said, we will confiscate those nasty, dirty, and mean-looking assault rifles. The backlash has been incredible. Over 80 of the 95 counties in Virginia declared themselves 2A sanctuary counties. The leaders of those counties, the law enforcement of those counties, and the people of those counties said that we will not abide by any of the laws coming from Richmond, Virginia. The Second Amendment supersedes them, so we will not enforce them. Now, that has all the liberals' panties in a wrinkle. They claim the status. They say, we are the state leaders, and you must abide by the law. They said, you took an oath to abide by the law. And they completely dismiss the Second Amendment, but the law that they create. All right, so as they were piling on the gun control, they said they want a red flag laws, which are completely unconstitutional. That's where you have to prove your innocence. Okay, after the fact, after they steal your property illegally, you are void of all due process, and then you have to prove before a crime has even been committed. All right, red flag laws are horrible, and in my opinion, extremely illegal. They want assault rifle confiscation. And they said that, you know, we will tell you how this is going to go down. We want universal background checks. We want a magazine capacity restrictions, and we want registration across the board. And the people are saying, no, we're not going to abide by this. And this is where there is a showdown in Virginia. The elite liberal government and the people, they forgot we the people and our rights shall not be infringed. So now the governor found himself, you know, he found his Peter in a nutcracker here. What exactly am I going to do? We have all these law enforcement leaders of these counties saying the Second Amendment supersedes your ridiculous law. So he says, I will, if I have to, I will cut off funding to those counties. Then he says, this is crazy, he says that he will get the Virginia National Guard to, you know, take over and prosecute and confiscate. But then he backed off a little bit. You know, once people were saying, hey, look, Ralph, you're kind of going overboard here. We don't really want a war that could be coming, by the way. A war could be coming because I don't think the good people of Virginia are going to take this quietly. So far, they have not. And they're giving no indication that they're going to back down. So old Ralph Northam there, the governor of Virginia, says, well, we're going to create a grandfather clause that we will allow you, these are his words, we will allow you to keep your assault rifles so long as you register them. Now, I interpret that as saying, we know you don't like confiscation, so we're just going to postpone that for a different date in the future. And that is completely unacceptable as well. So no, there won't be red flag laws in the sanctuary 2A counties. No, there won't be registration. No, there won't be confiscation of any kind. And then we'll see what happens with background checks and magazine restrictions. This is what the liberals have wanted all along. We're seeing it as soon as they get the power, right? Elections have consequences. This is what they want. But at no point will this make the good people of Virginia any safer. If they got everything they wanted, and for some crazy unknown reason, everybody said, you know what? You are the leaders. We'll give you whatever you wanted. It still wouldn't be enough. That's why the good people of Virginia say, we will compromise nothing. We declare ourselves a sanctuary county. That's how it's going to be. And we'll see how this whole thing works out. But there's a showdown in Virginia. It's happening, and it's rather fascinating to see the pro-2A people fight back and say, you know, elections have consequences, but we don't have to abide by your stupid laws because we believe in the Second Amendment, the right to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed. I appreciate you watching, and you guys be safe.